Welcome to CHTV. This is the place to be seen and heard, and today we are doing something completely different. We welcome today the producer of this show. That's right, it's Rycki Symons, and he's joining us today to chat about our very exciting formula program. Our love of film and this amazing product CHTV is now stepping up into a new platform. We are going to be delivering an incredible program to help you get camera ready with our tools and our skills that have helped us produce CHTV. It is your time now and your turn to step up and be seen from our perspective as we coach and train you with our incredible Get Camera Ready formula training. Join us now as we welcome Rycki Symons. Welcome to CHTV. It's your turn now to be on set.
Well, of course, Christina, this is not what I call my comfort zone. This is where you live and play for CHTV. So I'm always behind the camera and in post-production or some other aspect of the production of CHTV. But you know what? It was time for me to step up because you and I have been, I guess, developing the formula program for quite a few years now. And it's time.
Well, let's talk about the Get Camera Ready Formula Program, because that's the reason why you're here today, right?
Absolutely. This program is revolutionary, to say the least. We've released it, and you and I have been training with corporates, entrepreneurs, and wonderful business people of the future. And I guess it's time that it became very visible, and everyone finds out, I guess, about this, because it's far too good to be kept hidden anymore.
You know, you are the creative genius behind CHTV, but your creative genius started a long time ago. You have an incredible 25 years of RTO training experience that you bring to this incredible, incredible space. So this is very exciting for entrepreneurs and corporates as they really start to understand what it is they're going to really experience in this Get Camera Ready program.
Well, you know, if nothing else, it's my RTO experience, I guess, for the last 25 years that has brought me to this position forward and brought us to where we are today. And you know as well as I do, if we didn't have that, we wouldn't be, I guess, as good at what we do. We wouldn't be masters of what we do. We wouldn't be great or confident to step out and actually tell the world about what we do. And that's the step that we're at the moment. And I've shelved 25 years of amazing experience running an RTO and being in training and education yourself. You know exactly what that entails, the amount of preparation, course writing, working behind the scenes and in front of the front line of training. There's so much depth to RTO training, and we packaged all of that, and we are here today, I guess, to move it forward into our new direction.
And it's not just any old RTO. I mean, this was the Academy of Design. This is a fashion-based background. I mean, this is where our styling and our branding and looking amazing, it all comes together. And you know, it was 17 years ago that I met you, and I was very fortunate to be one of the fashion trainers at the Academy of Design. So I got to firsthand witness your creative genius. I mean, your illustrations are absolutely to die for. Absolutely amazing work. You should check them out. And so this particular genius zone you've brought into this program, and it's totally blown me away.
Well, to tell you the truth, I've lived a blessed creative life. Okay, there's no doubt about that. And I've, if nothing else, I've had the privilege of being creative, being born creative, and then being able to I guess, imprint or make some impact on thousands of students, okay, and that I can't tell you what that feels like. I guess I could tell you, because you were 17 years ago, you were at that front line at the Academy, and it became a creative force to be reckoned with. And all kudos to you and I. We were at the front line forging its path into what became an amazing leading creative industries college in its 17 years of getting to the top. And we've got to the top, and now we're ready to actually move in a completely different direction, but with all of the skills that we built in that time.
And you know, what's really interesting is that you're now ready to give this incredible genius to entrepreneurs and business people. You've moved away from that student portal. What made that shift for you? Like, why was it important for you to go through these changes and get to this next level?
Amazing question, because I've been asked and challenged so many times, why would you give up something that was built so beautifully over this time period? And you got to the top of your game, won hundreds of awards, did all of this huge work and this body of work. However, it's the world is changing. And I, at the heart of me, being an innovator, I'm also a futurist. And being a futurist, you have to look into the future. And it's not the fact that I'm giving up mentoring or training or education or any of that. I've just shifted my focus to who I want to move forward in the next step. And that has got to be, I guess, entrepreneurs, business people, people that are excited about taking on something for the future. And as much as I would have loved to have stayed in that, evolution and change is important for me too.
So for the viewer's sake, Academy of Design wasn't just about fashion. I mean, there are quite a few creative industries in there. Tell us about those.
Well, of course, because I actually was first and foremost a photographer. And that was my first love. I trained for photography, became a photographer, and then I went into fashion. I went into graphic arts next. Mm. And I moved into all of these creative fields, and it feels like I was perpetually studying. Mm. And that was what was amazing, because I never stopped. It's taken me into film and television, and this is where I get all of my production skills from. I've worked as a commercial photographer, and I guess, not just in fashion, I've shot for graphic arts, I've shot for clients, I've shot for web. And I would have to say that I wouldn't have it any other way. The amount of diversity that I've enjoyed in my career is incredible. I have such a legacy even for myself when I talk about the Academy. However, change is so important as well.
So you've met some incredible business owners throughout that time period, and you have a very impressive list of people that you've worked with. So that's quite incredible. So tell us some of those people that you would have worked with that really inspired you.
I have to tell you, I've worked on huge events. I've taken Academy students to incredible spaces and incredible experiences. And the fashion students, I've taken them to Melbourne and Sydney for Fashion Week. I have taken our photographers out on location. I've even packed them up into four-wheel drives and taken them onto Fraser Island, right? So that we can be out in the wilderness shooting something extraordinary. I do have an inquiring mind, and one that never settles. And I think that is a good sign, I guess, for a creative.
Yes.
And all of these experiences and all of the business people and all of the people that have given me and the Academy these experiences have made me more knowledgeable and attached to my business side. Mm. And this is why I don't feel the jump in the future is that great. Because as much as I've been in the creative pot playing for so long, I've also been in the business side of it. Mm. And what it becomes is then the perfect blend. And I'd like to think that I'm somewhere in the mess in the middle, enjoying both fields. And in that case, I have a lot to tell people.
Thank you.